Hello everyone, it's me Julie and I'm back with another video. Today I'm going to be unboxing a little personal stereo, a personal cassette player and recorder. I got this off Amazon and it was about £20. The reason for this is I was talking with my niece, who's only 16, and this is a concept she's never had anything to do with. Do you know what I mean? In her life, it's all been MP3s and things like that and digital music. So this was something I had as a child. My first personal stereo was a red personal stereo. I think I got it from Curry's, and the brand was Seisho. It didn't even have a rewind button. You had to take the tape out, turn it over, put it back in and fast forward it to be able to rewind the tape. So anyway, she was just talking about getting one. She had some cassettes. I don't know where she picked them up from, but she wants to play them. So we've both got one of these. Hers hasn't arrived yet, but mine is here. So I'm gonna open it and see what it's about. I'm not sure there are headphones in here, although it says that there are, it shows that there are, but I have these here just in case the ones in here are no good. First of all, I've got to be able to open it. I don't have any scissors with me. But anyway, let me get the scissors. I have the scissors, the hair scissors that are nice and sharp, to just cut that little bit of tape. Come on. Okay, here we are. Oh, there's tape all around. And this is the Groove E personal cassette player and recorder. So it records. Okay. So I don't know if you can see here. There's an image of some headphones or something, but it seems that if I open it, this is what we have here. They will not fit in my ears. My ears are really weird or small. Actually, maybe. Okay, they do fit, but they are not comfortable. No. They can go aside. So what do we have here? There is some sort of instruction. Oh, it feels really cheap and good. So here it is. This is the personal stereo Groove E. And you can see we have a series of buttons. There's a play, a record, a stop, a fast forward, and a rewind. I don't know if that's some sort of, oh, that's the microphone. And you can see here, there is a speaker. There is no eject button. You just literally open it and take this off. And it takes two AA batteries. And I have some here. So let me put those in now. Right. So which way do they go? This way. Sounds so cheap because that's what it's like. Right, so talking of tapes, now I've got a few things that I found. I was looking through an old box and I found a series of cassettes that I can try out, and I've got to share with you what I found. So first off, I found this kind of limited edition Mariah Carey Rainbow Snippets tape, which has got quite a few tracks that you can listen to. There's Heartbreaker, Bliss, Ex-Girlfriend, How Much Did I Do That, Cry Baby, Thank God I Found You, and another Heartbreaker remix with Debrat and Missy Elliott. Got a Daniel Bedingfield, Daniel Bedingfield Cassingle, because that's what we used to call them. A cassette single, we used to call them Cassingles. Then this is where it gets really good. This is a Memorex tape, and this is when you had a blank tape and you would record your own things on it. And this actually has Boys to Men. So I remember my brother was a massive Boys to Men fan. You can see I've actually got the track listing there, plus some other random things on the other side. So we can try that. I don't know, this is a TDK tape. This just says fun stuff. What could be on here? This, when I was 17, I used to work for Halfords. why I've got a Halfords customer care tape with the tab covered over, indicating that I've recorded something else on here. That's going to be interesting to hear. I've got a Pointer Sisters album from 1983. I think this was my dad's. I don't know where the case is, but that would be good to listen to. And then this, I remember this. I went somewhere. I think it was Earl's Court. There was some sort of thing, and Capital Radio were there. Capital Radio 95.8 FM. None of this digital business. And you could go into a booth and record your own jingle. And I remember recording like a jingle, like an intro to Eternal State. And I'll let you listen to that in a bit. So let's go back to the, what should we start with? Let's put the Mariah Carey in. Let's see. I mean, I don't know. Side A, side B, it's not at the beginning or the end. So I'll put side one in. So you can see you just, it just goes in the little hole, in the slot there. And then it's in, then you close it. Not a very good sound from the external speaker, so let me put some headphones on. Not that you'll be able to hear, but let me see if So that was How Much with Usher and Mariah Carey. It sounds bad like it used to, but you know, that's the whole point of it. I just love it. And the fact that it has that, the belt clip, like you would shove it on your waistband and walk around with your headphones on thinking you were really cool with your Groove-E personal stereo. It's actually got a radio on it as well. So if I change the function, tape, let's go to radio, tape that out. That sound. What can you even find?
London teacher Sabina Nessa says she's delighted that judges are being given more powers to make serious offenders attend their sentencing hearings.
They bloody well should. Well, I would say that the radio sounds better than the tape recordings. So, I'm just going to go through the tapes. I'm going to get to the part of the tape, this one, where I did my like introduction to Eternal Stay, and let you hear that. How funny. That's Power of a Woman. Why is that there? So I'm currently rewinding the tape. Does it have auto stop? Let's listen. What's coming up? Nothing. Let's go back. I just had to be patient. Gosh, I thought I was doing Stay, which is why when it played Power of a Woman in the first place, I thought it was something else. I sound so young, but literally I was probably under 20. But what happened, not that you need to know this, but in 1996, I was at some sort of concert for Eternals in some field in Chelmsford. And I lost my voice completely, completely. There was no sound at all and no pain, which is how it got damaged even further. And my voice changed from that high pitch, this, it changed from that to this tone now. Obviously, I'm older now, so my voice is naturally has naturally got deeper. But the damage I caused myself from the screaming and shouting caused this voice now, which I actually really like. That voice, who is that? Let's listen again. And I remember I was really nervous when I was doing it, and so I sound a bit trembly, but oh my God, let's listen.
Hi, my name's Julie and I'm from Lewisham, live at the 95.8 FM Capital Extravaganza.
Capital.
This is London's number one hit music station, broadcasting 24 hours a day with all your favourite DJs playing all the greatest chart hits. So right now, let's get things moving with Eternal and the Power of a Woman.
Who is that person? I sound so common as well. But anyway, this is the little, look at me. This is the little personal stereo. I just think it's exciting. I can't wait for my niece to get hers because I ordered both of them. Mine has come, but it says hers is going to arrive by 10 this evening. So we'll go around. I'll go around or she'll come here and we'll explore these together. But actually, let's have a listen to some Pointer Sisters. Where are we at? Side two. I don't even know what's on each side because I don't have the track listing. Right. Okay, you'll take us down, eh? What, I'm scared. I'm even scared to put in this Halfords tape. Like, what have I? Oh, I don't know what that was. Let's rewind it slightly and see what's happening. All right, let's turn it over and see what's on the other side. Did I just take the tape from work to make record? I'm sorry, I must have just taken the Halfords customer care tape just to record music. I used to buy my, what is that? Anyway, fun stuff. Let's see what's on fun stuff. Nothing fun there. Could be really embarrassing. Oh, this is Whitney Houston. I like Get It Back. So, what else have I looked at? What's that's there? Right, no, anyway, this is what you're here for, if you're here at all for this, which you should be. It's really lightweight and cheap, and that's exactly what I wanted, because it was £20. It plays the music through the speaker, or you can put your headphones in. It does come with some, everything's dropping, with some really cheap, nasty earphones that probably won't stay in your ear. There is no sponge to cover them, so they'll be very, maybe, are they painful? My ears, they never stay in, but we'll see. Well, let's see how long they can stay in before they fall out through this video. Yeah, there was an instruction thing. Let's just see what it says. It's basically telling you what the buttons do. It's an instruction manual. But, you know, I'm an expert. I've had one of these since 1987. Yeah, there's nothing that you need. Oh, it does tell you about cassette tape tips that you can use. Yeah, we used to do that. We used to put pencils to forward and rewind. And also if there was like some slack in the tape that needed to be tightened, you would put that in there. But yeah, at school, literally, if your cassette needed rewinding and you didn't want to waste your batteries, you'd stick a pencil in there and like move it around to rewind it manually. But no, I'm happy with that. And I do wish that Sony and Panasonic and the other brands that used to make them would do them again, like proper high quality ones. I'd pay. I've got tapes, and these aren't even all the tapes I've got. I would pay a good lot of money for a Sony Walkman. My sister had a blue Sony Walkman. Oh, I was so jealous of her Sony Walkman. At the time when she had that one, I had one by a company called, Matsui. So the one I had first was Seisho, that was Curry's own brand. Then Matsui was Dixon's own brand. So if Sony make Walkmans again. And there was this yellow Sony Walkman that was like underwater. You could go underwater. I don't quite see how, but it was waterproof. And then there were things, they had auto reverse, so you didn't even have to turn the tape over. It would somehow play the other side. I remember a girl at school said that her Walkman could do that. And I was like, nonsense. You're telling me that you could put a tape in and it would play side A and without turning it over, it play side B. Nonsense. Little did I know there was such a thing called auto reverse. But yeah, and this red button here is the record button. So let's actually, I don't want to wipe something. So maybe what I should do, I'll come back to you when I've put a tape in a decent place and try out the recording section of this. Okay, wait there. It's so funny. I've been trying to fast forward to the end of a song. It's like, there's no way you know where you are. You're halfway in a song. Anyway, I don't know why it's called Fun Stuff, because I don't quite know why I labelled the tape Fun Stuff, but there's just random songs. This is, I've been thinking about you. I can't remember who sang it. Oh, in love. What can I do? I've been thinking about you. I mean, why is that Fun Stuff? I'm trying to get to the end of the song. But you just have no idea where you are. So you're stopping and falling still. And you just don't know. Oh, there's a bit of silence. And I wouldn't have left that much. Is that the end of the tape? It is. You can see that's the end of the tape. So what is the beginning of the other side? And like, how did you know when you were recording on the tape how much space you had left? Yeah, so how did you know? How did you know, like, if you wanted to record another song onto your tape, you had no idea how much you had left. So you could start recording a song and then halfway through the song, or with 10 seconds towards the end, it could just stop. Anyway, what's the beginning of this side? And then how did you know when it was... Yeah, but I've already had this. That's Whitney. Right, so if I fast forward the Whitney, sorry, if I fast forward the Whitney, do you think it's at the end of the song? Let's find out. No. It's not just like skip to the next track, it's just guess. Do you think it's there yet? Let's see. No! Let's see. Now? No. That sounds like it's near the end. No. You just don't know. It's coming to the end. Let's just see what's next. Because I like that song. And I don't know if I've got it on CD. I do have Apple Music, so I can get it anyway. But come on, Whitney. It sounds like the same thing again. Right, I don't care. So, you press the play and the record buttons. And I think, actually, if I just press the record, they both go down anyway. Hello, this is Julie, testing the Groove E for its recording capabilities. Let's play it back now and see what it sounds like. Okay, so that's the end of the Whitney. So hopefully, and I was like, oh, it's just starting again. So it should stop. Let's play it back now and see what it sounds like. It didn't even record over the song properly. Did you hear that? As I was speaking, you could still hear the Whitney Houston underneath. So I guess if you're recording over something, no, it's not going to work. So if you're using a blank tape, that would be best if you wanted to record it. And also the playback level is poor and quiet, but I'm still really excited about this little contraption. So this is the Groove E AM FM radio cassette player recorder. Radio recorder cassette player. Let me get it right. There we are. See ya. Oh, and look, didn't fall out, but they're not comfy and they don't sound good. Bye.